Now we'll see that what we have done till now. Just stop this one. Okay. First, I have created that one database, that is a RatingDB. In the RatingDB database, I have created that two tables. One is that article table. You can see that there is an article. Another one is that comments tables. With that article ID is that foreign key, guest ID, comment description, rating, and commented on. Okay, that all things has been added. Now open the Visual Studio. First, what we have done, first we have added that one, that your entity model in the models folder. If you look that one here, you can see that I have added that entity model here. And after that, we have created one controller, that is the home controller. First of all, I have created that entity object of a OBJ rating DB entities, and in that DB entities, I'm getting that all those article in that ionumerable and passing to that index view. If you look that index view, I'm passing to here that I'm getting that ionumerable with that particular article view model. So I have created one table. If you look that one table, that is a table, and I am filling that particular table, and I have created one action link that with that name text is that add view comment. Another one is that action name is that show comment, and I'm passing that a route value is that article ID is that item dot article ID. Okay, now open that home controller show comment. If you look at it here, I'm getting that one, that only those comment which have article ID is where I'm going to be making the condition where article is ID is that article ID. Okay, and I'm assigning that all those value. Okay, that one is okay. Next one, what we have done, we are passing that particular value to that. If you will look at here I'm passing that one show comment, but if you will look here, that was show comment, that is a show comment. But in the show comment, I am making that for each loops, but I have created that of one partial view. Okay, so if you open that comment partial view, if you come here, that you can see here that I have added that partial view. With that, I'm checking that first, I'm displaying that commented on. One more thing we can display here, that is your, in the show comment, that is your article name. In that, instead of your show comment, we can display here that article name. Okay. So in that partial view, if you will look here, that particular model commented on, first one I'm displaying the commented on. Here we can add that more field, more thing, that is HH. So we can display the time also, that HHMM. And next one I'm displaying that comment description, and what all this comment description with that rating. What here they is checking that one, if a rating is a 3, so making for each loop with that 3. And next one I'm displaying that one, that empty. It's like instead of, because 5, if a rating is the 3, so 3 is that active, and rest 2 here I'm displaying that is say deactive. Okay, once open the server comment, here I have added that begin form, adding the first I have added the text area, second I am adding that one div with that 5 span. With the 5 span, that is a some event is there, see mouse mouse out, on mouse over, on mouse on click. So, and one more thing is a C rate selected. But for the hover means like if you are hovering that, it will be this C, that one it will be field. If you go to the out, it will be the empty. If you click, so it will be assigned to the one hidden variable, that is if you will look that one here, I mentioned that level rating. So you can see here that one we are assigning that particular value. And while clicking on the save, if you look, you can see here I am giving the name of everyone, that is for that button save comment, that for that article ID and the rating also. And one more thing is that is a article comment. The same, that three thing I am passing to that one action method, that is the add comment. If you look here, that is a displaying here, and this data I am saving. If we look once around one more time, if you click here, you can see all those is displaying that one. If it will not group once you are going to use that CSS, instead that's I'm saying that if you use here you can see that is a so command, and you can make a one back button also. That all things we can do, but in that in this video we are fully concentrating of that for the rating star rating part. So because here I am using that bootstrap, if you want you can use that image, you can create that two image and you can assign like that with the help of a span. Instead of that class you can create that two class. That's because here I am using that one. If you look here I am using that bootstrap class. Look at this one is a class, that is a bootstrap class. Instead of this you can create your own class and you can assign that particular image, so that image will display. Just remove this one, that you can create the two image, one for active, another for deactive. You can assign that one, replace this one, this particular class to that particular class name, that your custom class names, because I am using here that bootstrap. So if you look that, it's looking good. You can create one button here, so if once you are going to click on back, so it will be redirect to here. I hope it's clear. Thanks for watching.